We have seen how the stock market investors or traders have been allocating a lot of capital into renewable energy and EV companies. The industry has gotten very, very hyped, and even more with SPAC mergers. But today I will talk about an EV company that might go public through an IPO, initial public offering, this year. Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today I will talk about the next big IPO, and that company is Rivian. I will talk about the company, how it might be an excellent investment in the long term, what my expectations are, and what I will be doing with this company if they go public. If you're new to my channel, welcome. Please consider subscribing for more content and smash that like button, since it really, really helps the channel out. Also, I have a completely free Discord group chat, which the link for that is down in the description below. Rivian is an EV company that people are saying could compete with Tesla with their car models, since they have a pickup truck and kind of the Range Rover SUV model. This is a company that was founded in 2009 and is one of the most eagerly anticipated EV makers, and could have way more potential than many of these EV companies that have gone public in the past year. As you can see, they currently offer only two models. I'm not saying only two models as a bad thing. I think it is actually excellent that they offer these two models. They offer the R1T, which is a pickup truck, and the R1S, which is kind of the futuristic Range Rover, in my opinion. The pickup truck starts at $67,000 with a range of over 300 miles, which are expecting to deliver a 400 miles range pickup truck by 2022, and a cheaper version with only 250 miles range. But the only one that they will have available this year is the launch version, which is not the cheaper one and will cost $75,000, and will be available in June 2021. The rest are expected to be available by January 2022. The other model, the R1S, will start at $70,000, so a little more price with a 300 miles range as well. They will also offer three different models for this one. The launch starting at $77,500, and delivery is expected to start by August 2021. Obviously, as they are electric vehicles, they would compete directly with Tesla, but the thing is, the price is way different and it might be targeting different people as well. The Model X, for example, starts at $89,000, so a little more expensive than their SUV, and their Cybertruck will start at $39,000, but has less than 300 mile range. So yes, it is cheaper, but has less range as well. Still, Tesla is already offering a 500 miles range vehicle at almost $70,000, but has not started delivery nor production yet. Unfortunately, we do not have any kind of access to Rivian's financials yet, so we cannot know exactly how they are doing their growth or what to expect from it. So we cannot know what a good valuation for this company is. But the company was last valued at $27.6 billion in the private markets after they raised $2.65 billion funding round in January, meaning that the company has raised about $8 billion since 2019. But Rivian is seeking a valuation of at least $50 billion, which would definitely be the biggest EV IPO ever, since Tesla had $1.7 billion market cap when its IPO, NIO $6.4 billion, XPeng $11 billion, and Li Auto $10 billion. Now, as I said, we do not have access to their financials to be able to know if they are able to back up that huge valuation, but we do know that apparently their demand right now is greater than the numbers of cars they can build on a yearly basis, meaning that their supply is constrained through 2021. And also know about the deal they have with Amazon. Rivian also has a deal with Amazon to build 100,000 custom electric delivery vans by 2030. In the near term, the company say 10,000 of the vans will be on the road making deliveries by 2022. Rivian will build three different models of the van, which are capable of going about 150 miles on a single charge. And also, Amazon is already testing the van in LA. We know that Amazon have been testing drones and will try to have their fleet completely autonomous, which obviously is an excellent opportunity for Rivian, and even more since the deal is already signed. I think all that is nice, even though we don't know their financials, because if we are going to invest in a company with no no revenue, which is not that recommended. At least you would like to see very, very large pre-orders, confirmed pre-orders, and huge companies backing them up. I do think or know that at this moment, people do not care about financials for EV companies because they are the future and the potential growth is incredible, and they are trying to find the next Tesla investment, in my opinion, and that is why we have seen so much hype around the industry. But I do think that this company has potential because of their product, since literally pickup trucks demand is increasing in the US every single day, and offering an electric pickup truck with all these nice features, which if you haven't seen them yet, go check them out. They have a very nice video explaining them, could help the company with a massive growth. Their delivery timeline looks excellent, and in my opinion, supposedly their demand is huge, but I do want to see how they unfold, how they deliver their product, and what people think about their product when they get it. Something we do have to keep in mind is, first, they are just starting to create their own charging network, which means that at the beginning, customers might need to rely on public or third-party networks, just like ChargePoint, for example. It is not a big deal, but at the same time, it is, and also we do have to know that they are miles behind Tesla. Their first delivery will come out within the next months, which means we might not see huge revenue or volume within the next year, and they have not been able to demonstrate their ability to scale. As I have said before, we know that that is very important for every company, and even more in this industry, because we have seen how Tesla has suffered with it, and that could easily drag a company to bankruptcy. I think that is what mostly differentiates Tesla right now as an investor, because EV companies need a lot of time and money and at the beginning, and not every company will be able to demonstrate that scale or growth capacity. Obviously, time will tell with other EV companies, but that is very, very important to understand when investing in this type of companies. Obviously, I will do another video talking about this company when they release their financials, but I do think it has potential and might be a nice investment, but that is something I will only be capable of confirming after we know more about the company and their financials. I do know that there will be a hype around the company, but do like that they might go public with an IPO instead of a SPAC merger, because we will not see what is currently happening with companies like CCIV. Before talking about CCIV, remember that with Webull, you are able to track any IPO. After you get to their Webull app and you go to the IPO center, here you can see all the companies that just filed for IPO, for going public. Then on the offering tab, you can see all the companies are already offering their stocks. For example, if we select Virpax Pharmaceutical Inc., you can here see that they filed for IPO on October 9th and started their offering on February 10th with a price range of $10 to $12 per share. What is nice about Webull is that they let you buy a stock or IPO before they even go public. For example, with this company, you can click here in order now and buy their stock before they get listed at a price range of between $10 and $12. The nice thing about this is that if they go public tomorrow, let's say they're going public on February 17th, but if they go public tomorrow and the stock opens at $20 per share, it's fine because you will still get your shares at between $10 to $12 per share. Obviously, they're not able to do that with every stock, but almost all of them. So I do recommend Webull for that. If you want to open an account with them, they are currently offering two free stocks when you open an account and deposit $100. The link for that is the first one in the description below. Now, CCIV is this SPAC company that apparently will acquire Lucid Models, which is another EV company that will apparently start deliveries in spring this year. And I have already seen charging stations in Miami, to be honest. The thing is that I think it is very, very crazy that the SPAC company CCIV has gone up a lot before even having a confirmation of the merger or even seeing their financials. I mean, the deal would be at $10 per share, and people are buying this stock at a 200 or 300% premium. I have said it before, if you want to play the hype and buy it and then sell it within days for a profit, do it. I do not recommend it, but it is what it is. And this is just gambling until the merger is confirmed. And that is why I have gotten so skeptical with SPAC mergers, because people do not care about the company or their financials or their growth or anything. They just know that the SPAC is going up because of the hype a lot before the merger, and that's all. And even more if it's a merger between a SPAC company and an EV company. Hope you enjoyed the video. Please smash that like button and subscribe, since it really, really helps the channel out. Remember, I have a completely free Discord group chat. The link for that is down in the description below. Thank you, and see you next time.